Let's do another trip to the United Exploitation Country. We already visited the casino and the photo manager, so let's continue this road and head to the animals. This is a 200 points exploitation challenge, and it doesn't provide us anything to reverse engineer, so we must be able to blindly exploit this. The description reads, after decades of research, we finally managed to catalog all the animals on the planet Earth, including very rare pictures. Oftentimes, the text can contain hints, but this one is so short and generic that it probably doesn't really include anything. So let's load the challenge onto the board and get started. Let's quickly check out the functionality. We see here a menu and a prompt where we can enter characters. The menu items indicate that we can enter a C to print a cat, or a D to print a dog, or an M to print a mouse. We can also try to enter some more characters, like write cat. While it still just prints what the first character says, it's interesting that we can enter more characters and get the whole string. So we could definitely try and see what happens when we enter more characters. You might already notice some odd behavior, but let's not get ahead of ourselves. This was my mistake I first made when I approached this challenge. Let's do this systematically. I decided to use a whiteboard to visualize what goes on in my head as well as to document each discovery. Especially with blind challenges like this, you need to build a good mental model of the program running there, and taking notes is crucial. So I start with writing down what I know. There are the three different characters in the menu, M, C, and D, so I wonder, is there maybe a hidden menu option? Let's find out. Let's write some code that tries out every character and we look at the response. By now you already know this code, this just sets up the serial connection with the board and some helper functions. So first we read until we get the menu enter prompt so we can send a character, and it makes sense to put this into a loop. So now we print the last output, construct our payload, which is just one character, and enter it into the menu. Then we read the result and try the next character. When we try to run it, it doesn't find serial. I forgot to enter the virtual environment. If you do any Python programming, make sure to check out virtualenv. So now it works and it tries every character, but it's a lot of output. I think it's better if you remove all the new lines and also show the raw bytes with wrapper. Now it's easy to spot stuff. When you now look through here, we notice that some characters, for example, the percentage sign, are turned into null byte. There are a couple of them. No idea if it's important in some way or not, but let's make sure to note these down. It's important to not ignore oddities like this. But besides that, we didn't find any secret menu option. So let's think of something else we could try. How about trying out different lengths of input? Let's modify our code to test that. So instead of using the loop number as a character, we use it to change the length of the input, and we just try it with some A's. When we run it, we can observe multiple things. First of all, the input seems to be capped at like 59 or 60 characters. Our input keeps growing, but the output stops. So let's take notes of that. The first short length happened obviously very quickly. So if we look there again, more closely, we notice that with the 11th character, we screw with something and suddenly leak a lot of bytes. Let's write it down. So that's very interesting. What is so special at this last character position? We can write some code to explore that further. Let's enter a couple of C's and then play with the exact value, and here's a very interesting result. You see, we always enter a bunch of C's, but it only prints the amount of bytes we specify. So null byte will print nothing and 3 will print 3 characters, and so when we get to the high byte values, like actual ASCII characters, we obviously leak like 30 or more bytes. It doesn't leak up to 255 bytes, so there's a limit, but we can write this down. And we can change from 11th char dumps memory to that the 11th char controls the output length. So now we know that we have this big range of memory we can write to, and certain positions can contain important information. So for example, the 11th character is the print length. And to take notes, we can enter the byte that we leak into this long array. Also, the ASCII character number 7, hex 37, prints the maximum amount of output. So now we wonder, what could other positions in this memory here mean? When we fuzz the input length, we use the character A. So I'm wondering, what if we use another character that actually prints a picture, like C, the cat? So modify the code slightly and then let's see what happens. And very quickly the cat disappears. And if you do the same thing for dog, the dog picture disappears a little bit later. So you can write down how many characters it takes to reach a point where a particular picture is not shown anymore. That's very interesting. What could we possibly overwrite in memory that causes this behavior? Look at the memory we leaked and mark the apparently interesting offsets. It's clear that these bytes must mean something. These bytes have something to do with cat. So let's modify the code. I add 3 bytes I know are the correct value, but replace the first one to try different bytes. But it doesn't do anything. It seems like there's only one correct value that leads to printing the cat. In retrospect, it's probably like a stack cookie. We must use that one particular value. So let's move on to the next byte. Do the same thing. And this time it does print the cat more often. That's a bit weird. I have a strong feeling that this is part of an address, but I don't know. Let's move on to the third byte. Oh, holy crap. This is clearly moving the cat around. So that is definitely part of the address, or offset into memory where the cat is stored. Also, it's very interesting to see some weird characters before and afterwards. It's not just zero, and clearly not just random garbage, so that's something we shouldn't ignore. But we still didn't get a big breakthrough. Now, if you look at the leaked memory dump, you will notice that the dog and mouse seem to have 4 interesting bytes, while the cat only has 3. Maybe the 4th byte of the cat just happens to be 0, but actually it has also those 4 bytes. Ignore some of the notes here, I was just exploring some random ideas. Anyway, let's try the 4th byte. Whoa! This output is damn interesting, this is gold! If you look very closely, you notice that these weird characters have indeed a pattern. Doesn't this look like the dog? The shape is here, just the wrong characters. And this looks like the mouse. This really stinks like XOR. The pattern is here, just the characters have to be transformed into something else. So let's write a simple Python script that tries out different XOR keys, applies them to this leaked character output and prints it. And when we now look through the possible outputs, we find a clear text mouse. So to recap, we have a big chunk of memory, and at certain offsets we know there is some kind of information regarding the animal pictures. At least the 2 last bytes affect where we read from memory. We were able to extract an XOR picture from the mouse by changing the bytes of what corresponded to the cat, so we clearly control here the location of memory we read, but the output is XOR'd. So now we have a first serious shot at getting the flag. Let's modify our loop to iterate over all 2 byte values. Then we take the leaked memory output, pass it to a function that brute forces all possible keys, and our assumption is that some memory location will contain the flag, just XOR'd. So if we find the word flag in any of the decrypted memory leaks, we win. Makes sense, right? So let's try that. Oh man, I did first make here a mistake. I meant to brute force the 3rd and 4th byte, but if you look closely, I brute forced the 2nd and 3rd. Obviously that didn't work. So after fixing that and some other minor mistakes, I let it run, and it pretty much immediately outputs the flag. Let's hand it in and collect our 200 points.